Time and space are modes by which we think, and not conditions in which we live.
Well, you've got, you're entering the six dimensions.
Six dimensions?
Yes, you're entering the six dimensions. This is an exploration into triangular space, and these are some of the images of it. These snowflakes are all based on actual crystals. Yeah, there was a scientist named William Bentley. He spent 7 years in the mountains in Jericho, Vermont, photographing these. And what we did is we would take glass that was left over from windows, and we would build these windows, these snowflake crystals, based on these actual crystals. And each one is unique. And there are, you know, there's patterns in them.
How do you get the shapes and the crystals? You said you get them from a photograph?
Yeah, there was a scientist named William Bentley. He spent 7 years photographing these images of snowflake crystals. And from those, we would research the different types. Like, there's ones with high moisture, there's temperature, and there's atmospheric pressure. And those determine how the snowflake crystals grow. And we do manifestations of those different forms of crystals, and then build them from actual images of real snowflake crystals. So they're like replicas of real crystals.
From snowflakes?
Yeah, from snowflakes, yeah. And the thing that I noticed about them is they have triangular symmetry.
Oh, okay.
And that's like a common structure in nature. And that's what driving me to do what I'm doing, is to show how this there's this triangular symmetry in nature.
Oh, they say that every snowflake is unique. There's never a duplicate. Is that true of these crystal formations?
Well, actually, that's not 100% true, because this is an example of a twin right here. This one started out as a high altitude snowflake crystal. The high altitude crystal forms is a little tiny like a quartz crystal. And this forms at about 60,000 feet. This will form if it's like 20 below zero or colder. And if there's a snowmaking cloud coming in at 30,000 feet, which is the normal height for a snowflake crystal, then the twin would form on either sides of it. And so here's an example of a snowflake with which are identical twins, like Siamese twins.
Twin snowflakes. No one had thought it.
So we have to throw out one of our known paradigms that we think of as no two snowflakes alike. It is possible to have two snowflakes alike.
So they're completely alike.
Yeah, these are identical. Right. well, the thing is that there's probably many of them that are forming identical to each other, like at 30,000 feet. Mm-hmm. But by the time they hit the ground, they could be miles apart. Mm-hmm. So to try and prove it is like difficult. But this shows that it is possible. Mm-hmm. That there are twins being formed probably all the time. But it's hard to prove it.
Okay.
Because there's billions and billions and billions of them being formed, like just during one snowstorm.
Yeah. And I guess you don't have crystal formations of every single one, do you? You don't have billions of stained glass versions of crystal formations.
No, I don't have billions, but there's about 26 specific types of snow crystals, and I've got variations of those 26 different types. Again, it's moisture content, temperature, and atmospheric pressure, and those are the variables. So whenever you get that triple set in a certain constant, like at a certain elevation, you're getting the similar kinds. But of course, the altitude of the cloud, if it's like a mile tall, you're going to get all different formations through that whole length of cloud while they're forming on a given snowstorm.
Oh, my goodness, this is going over my head, but this is great.
Sorry about that.